Welcome to Flora and Friends, your botanical cup of tea, a podcast for plant lovers of any kind. We welcome guests to our botanical tea break to explore the history, science, and meaning of plants for our lives. My name is Judith Lundbey-Felten. I'm a plant scientist, university researcher, and founder of Flora L Design, and I'm the hostess of your botanical cup of tea. A warm welcome to our introductory episode. Let me start with a question. What do you think of when you think of plants? Is it the plants in your garden? Is it the cactus on your windowsill? Is it a nice bouquet that you hope to get from somebody you love? May it be a big forest extending over miles and miles? It's really fascinating, isn't it? Plants are everywhere in our life. We eat them, we build with them, we make fiber for our clothing from them, we use them in pharmaceuticals, we use them for bioenergy, we use them for even nanomaterials nowadays. So there's really so much about plants that concerns our life. But how often do we really take the time to appreciate how fascinating plants are and how fascinating their story is? Have you ever wondered who discovered them? Who actually brought them to the place where you are living today? Who gave them a name? And why do they have these complicated Latin names? And what do they mean? The person that must have given all these names to all these plants, how did he come up with them? And maybe these plants have a story in a different part of the world or in a different part of your country where they mean something to people. Where they have been growing them, they have been breeding them for years or generations, and the whole family has maybe developed around this plant. There's so many fascinating stories about plants to discover and to see what their meaning is to our lives. On a scientific level, you can wonder how these plants actually function. How does your Christmas cactus know it's Christmas and start flowering? How do the trees know that it's winter soon and that they have to lose their leaves? How do the plants start to flower? Why does a carrot only flower every second year? And then if you start to look into them using a microscope, you see all these fascinating structures, these building blocks that make up their entire plant body, and every little cell there is important. I guess you hear it. I'm totally fond of plants, thinking about them basically the whole day. And that's why I've started this podcast, to reach out to you who also love plants and to those who maybe want to learn more about them. So what can you expect when you join me here for your botanical cup of tea? You will be able to enjoy new episodes 2 to 4 times per month, released on Wednesdays. You can sign up for our newsletter on flora-l.com in order to be informed and not miss any new releases. The episodes will be about 15 to 20 minutes, so ideal for a cup of tea or coffee or whatever you like to have with your break. We will usually dedicate several episodes to the same type of plant and explore the history of the plant, the science about that plant, and the use in different interviews with people that are specialists on these areas. And I hope that you will get a lot of new information and a lot of useful tips so that you can explore those plants also in your daily life. Maybe by now you have become curious to know where my love of plants actually comes from. Well, I became hooked by plants when I was a student in 2004 at the University of Strasbourg in France. And I remember that I was standing on this rooftop greenhouse at the university. It was a cold winter day, very grey, and it was warm and nice and lighted, of course, in the greenhouse. And you could get a glimpse over the roofs of Strasbourg, which is a very nice city if you ever get to visit it. But when I was standing there, like with my hands shaking seeds from these small Arabidopsis plants and trying to learn how all this actually works, I had this feeling that I want to be here. I want to spend my life among plants, trying to understand how they communicate with their equals, but also with other organisms, how they sense what is around them, like the environment, the temperatures, the pathogens that may attack them. Well, and that is where my road has then led me, from Germany to France to Sweden, eventually where I built up my own research group at the university. And now 17 years after this, standing in this rooftop greenhouse there in Strasbourg, I find I have been digging my nose very deeply into all the mechanisms of the plant. And I feel a desire to also want to see a more complete picture of plants. I want to talk to the people that are concerned by them, that work with them, that have a story about them, and to discover more the whole picture of plants in our everyday life. So I would like to invite you to join me on this journey through the plant world, learning about the flora close to us, but also far away on the other side of the planet. And I will talk to historians, botanists, plant scientists, plant breeders, florists, cooks, pharmacists, and people with plants in their backyard that have a fascinating story. So join me here on Wednesdays for Flora and Friends, your botanical cup of tea. I hope you have enjoyed this episode, and if you also want to appreciate plants visually under the microscope, then pay us a visit on www.flora-l.com and see how we make pattern from microscopy images of plants. You can also find us on Instagram at flora.l.design. And finally, if you have friends in your surrounding who also love plants, please share the word about our podcast with them. And if you are listening from a platform where you can rank us, and after a few episodes, Flora and Friends is still your cup of tea, we would really appreciate a positive review so that more plant lovers can find our podcast.